Ladies and gentlemen, as we are about 30 minutes from competition beginning, please remember that if you have friends and family who couldn't make it today, be sure to let them know they can tune in and watch the event live with Flow Wrestling. A Flow Wrestling subscription also includes access to watch on-demand videos from the event, a growing library of original content, and so much more. Visit Flow Wrestling at flowwrestling.org. to get started today. Also, ladies and gentlemen, if you are just joining us, a bit of a housekeeping issue for you. First off, only those coaches with valid coaching wristbands are allowed in the field of play. If you have a general admission wristband, you must stay outside the fencing. You cannot be on the field of competition or on the floor around the mats. You must stay on the spectator side of the fencing if you have a general admission wristband. Only coaches and active athletes are inside. Also, particularly since a number of you are just joining us for the youth tournament today, please be aware, the restroom facilities within this venue, by mat 6, are designated men and women. The restroom facility at the far side by mat 10 is women only on both sides. Ladies, do not get weirded out when you walk into the one that has urinals. That's for us too, because it's a women's tournament and they understand we gals kind of outnumber the guys here. Also, out in the hallway, out on the concourse, the bathroom on the opposite side of the wall from the bathroom that Matt sits in, designated women and men. The bathroom on the concourse side of the Matt 10 bathroom is also only women. Both sides. They have put up, the venue staff has put up temporary signage marking those bathrooms as women only.
Thank you. got a boom in the can. Thank you. All right. Me and you. Anybody with the formerly known as Texas Wrestling Team gets the plus two.
I'll authorize it. Begin.
I have water and snacks in the front in my white cooler if you want it. If not, whatever. How you guys doing? It's kind of a tough tournament, huh? I mean, normally I would expect more out of you guys. Everybody's performed as much as they could at this point. That was good. Even with Casey, she lost. She had a horrible tournament, but she got it out. So now we can move forward and maybe let's go and do some judo tournaments. Why not?
Thank you for bringing me. I think she's excelling pretty well with that. We just keep the group together. I have no clue how anybody did that. I was busy. I was in the front. He was trying to win this thing. He didn't pass me.
I think Lexi and Jasmine are the only ones.
You see all the people that are here today with.
I know I'm not as pretty, but I'm Mike.
Mike, you know what? You are absolutely right, but thank you for helping too.
I can hear. That's their only dog speaker, that one.
Great day today.
George. You be the judge, the first one.
Okay.
It's not that cold in here today.
Yeah.
I was freezing.
Yeah.
97 degrees out, and I'm in here with
a yeah. Yeah.
They need it all the time.
Attention athletes and coaches at this time, would you please begin clearing the mats? We are 5 minutes from competition. Correction, 4 minutes from competition. Please clear the mats.
You're 23 or something, yeah. Okay. It's 3 minutes, I thought.
Okay. At least you're 23 is easier to follow than the little ones where it's 50 points scored in 30 seconds.
Yeah.
Wait, yeah. What? Wait.
And I started reading out. Eventually, Green scores too, and there's only two guys.
Attention athletes and coaches, so you are aware, these will be the preliminary mat assignments for the U17s and 23s for round one at the championship level for the placement matches. And for the youth tournament, these will be until the U17s and 23s conclude their matches. U23 champ final round one will be on mat one. U23 third place will be on mat 2. U23 fifth place will appear on mat 4. U23 seventh place will appear on mat 6. U17 first round champ finals will be on mat 3. U17 third place match on mat 5. Fifth place match on mat 7. Seventh place match on mat 9. For the youth tournament, the 8U and 10U athletes will appear on mat 12, directly in back of the head table. The 12U athletes will appear on mat 11, and the 14U athletes to start will appear on mat 8 and 10. As we have mats open from the World Team Tournament, we will turn those over. As they tell me, I will announce it out. For the U17s and U23s, athletes, your second championship best of three series will be on the opposing mats. So in round two of the best of three series, the U23s will take mat 3, and the champ U17s will take the podium, will take the stage on that one. If we have any third round in the best of three series in U17 or U23, we will let you know how that will be operated.
I know, it's like, at least I get to watch a
whole
match.
Yeah. I'm like, how does she get the mat one?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, athletes, coaches, and officials. USA Wrestling welcomes you to the Amon G. Carter Jr.'s Hall of the Will Rogers Memorial Center here in beautiful Fort Worth, Texas. And the 2022 U.S. Marine Corps Women's National Championships and World Team Trials. Athletes from across the nation have traveled this weekend to the great state of Texas for this moment. On this special note, on this day especially, USA Wrestling takes a moment to honor all of our mothers for your sacrifice, your passionate dedication, and your boundless love and patience when it comes to dealing with the hangry of a wrestler. You, ladies, are the true champions of our beloved sport, and we salute you. Happy Mother's Day, y'all. Don't forget that this event is being streamed live today. Go to floatwrestling.org to catch all the action and archive footage of this event. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if you are able, would you please stand for a moment of silence as we honor those who served and remember those who made the ultimate sacrifice for our freedoms. Thank you. Now please remain standing as we honor our nation in the tradition of this women's tournament with the singing of our national anthem by U-17 athlete Ms. Gigi Bragg of Team Michigan. First call for Nyla Valencia, Bulldog to match number one. Now we bring on match number one. U23 women's first round, weight class 50 kilo. Nyla Valencia, a Bulldog wrestling wearing the blue, will be meeting a fam of Texas wrestling wearing the red. Second call for Nyla Valencia of Bulldog to match number one. First call for Katie Valdez.